In this video, we will discuss the implementation of Verizon Network Directive MERFS-DI-14002, installing and troubleshooting a simple passive CPRI fiber optic interface panel. The CPRI interface panel provides a non-service affecting monitor port. A CPRI protocol analyzer can be used to decode the optical link transmit data stream from a distributed antenna system CDIU, remote radio head, or active antenna. CPRI interface panels arrive as a complete kit to be installed in either a 19-inch or 23-inch freestanding rack or cabinet. Some kits include fiber optic patch cables used to connect the CPRI interface panel to the active baseband units. Color-coded fiber connectivity kits are available in different cable length sizes, ranging from 1 to 15 meters. Self-install kits include mounting brackets to be installed on the side of the interface and additional hardware to secure the CPRI interface to a standing rack. Cable management items consist of Velcro straps, management rings, zip ties, and warning stickers to alert technicians of active lasers. Factory test results for attenuation on the throughput ports and contact information for installation support are enclosed with each new CPRI interface panel. A reference guide to the 6 primary fiber color codes and their respective power pairs may be enclosed. This references port numbers and color-coded mating sleeves utilized in some CPRI interface panels. Fiber optic single mode cable is routed from radio heads to base station enclosures. Fiber optic cable is typically routed to a cross-connect in a cable management drawer or directly to a CPRI interface panel. CPRI interfaces are completely passive and require no adjustments. The interface panels can be used for either high or low band configurations, as they are not band specific in nature. It is recommended that one interface panel be installed per high band and a separate panel or module for low band. Indicating the sector or carrier on the front of the panel can assist performance engineers with testing the correct data streams. Route the fiber optic cable pairs from the remote radio head, active antenna, or cross-connect panel to the CPRI interface panel. A power pair color chart will be referenced on the CPRI panel and it may be marked to, from, radio head. Next, route the cables from the base station electronics to the CPRI interface panel. A power pair color chart will be referenced again on the other side of the panel and may be marked to, from, baseband. Be sure to clean every fiber optic connector and face and adapter port with correct tools. This ensures cleanliness of patched cables and achieves minimum attenuation and optical return loss. The 2RU CPRI interface with integrated cable management includes a self-install kit as well, used to connect the CPRI interface to baseband electronics. After installation into a rack, loosen the captive screw in the top right corner and the drawer will extend outward. The top deck CPRI module can be removed by pulling both release tabs, located next to the drawer rails. Bring the outside HyberFlex cable into the back, left side of the drawer and route counterclockwise, securing the cable under the pivoting tab. Continue to store cable slack utilizing Velcro straps as needed until fiber optic connectors are in position at the front left of the drawer. Then reinstall the CPRI top deck module. Plug in the fiber pairs from the radio head on the left side of the CPRI module. The blue center adapters are for spare fibers and are not active circuits. The fiber patch cables to and from the baseband are plugged into the right side of the CPRI module and routed out through the back right side of the drawer. Monitor ports are exposed on the front of the CPRI interface. This allows performance engineers to access test monitor ports without disturbing active fiber optic links. The 4RU CPRI interface chassis caters to high-density applications where rack space is limited. The chassis includes mounting brackets and cable management accessories. The CPRI interface modules and patch cable kits are ordered individually to scale up or down. This 4RU chassis is reversible, allowing technicians to locate the monitor ports in the front or rear of the rack. The chassis shown here is mounted with monitor access ports in the front. The decal installed on the panel provides cable routing instructions to and from both the baseband and remote radio heads. Another decal on the opposite panel door indicates the location of the uplink, downlink monitor ports. The CPRI interface modules used with this high-density chassis services 6 remote radio heads per module. Insert the module for 4RU from the monitor port access side of the chassis. Feed the module through the inside of the chassis and secure it by locking its push pins into place. After securing the module, insert the cables from the remote radio head and baseband electronics into their designated adapters. Reference the decal on the chassis panel door. Typically, the baseband cable will enter the left side of the module and the remote radio cable will enter the right side. Verify the test equipment to ensure the correct signal strength is routed to each non-service affecting monitor port. Troubleshooting the SIPRI interface is relatively easy, as the units are completely passive. Manufacturer warranties guarantee these products to be free from defect. Should the technician feel the SIPRI interface is not operating as intended, contact the manufacturer or regional support for immediate replacement or technical assistance. A visual fault locator, also known as red visible light, is an inexpensive tool that can be used to verify continuity and polarity. Clean the end faces of a patch cable, then plug in the VFL to the transmit port of the remote radio head adapter. Turn on the VFL, and the technician will recognize visible light at the monitor port and throughput port on the baseband adapter. This simple test will verify if the internal fibers are in good condition and that the unit is wired correctly. To maximize performance, it is extremely important to clean connector end faces prior to putting the SIPRI interface panel into service. Outside environments, handling, and humidity can cause contamination of end faces. Ferrule protection caps are often wrongly referred to as dust caps and can trap contaminants. Transit and storage can cause moisture or condensation inside packaging and within fiber connections. IEC standards on end face inspection is available on many handheld test devices. Simply cleaning with dry cleaners or a combination of cleaning with wet and dry cleaners provides best results and optimal performance. If continuity is present and connectors are clean, technicians can check for correct polarity, attenuation, and breakage. Only a basic power meter and light source is required for this test. Utilize two quality patch cables connected by a mating sleeve and zero set reference the meter. Once reference is set, insert the patch cord from source into the transmit side of the adapter on the to, from radio head, or BBU, typically on the right side of a duplex LC mating sleeve. Power level attenuation should be approximately 3 dBs. This indicates polarity is correct and you have intended power levels. For more information on installation and selection of SIPRI interface panels for optical SIPRI links in legacy or upcoming projects, contact a preferred supplier such as Fiber Instrument Sales.